Hi students, this is Dr. Rajaratna Thangavel, Faculty of Ophthalmology. In this particular video, we are going to talk about a very small topic called proptosis. Now, you know proptosis is a subtopic under orbit. Now, what is the word proptosis? See, pro means forward, okay, and ptosis means a kind of displacement. So, when we say proptosis, so there is a forward displacement. Forward displacement of what? Forward displacement of the eyeball. All right. Then, what is exophthalmos? So you have proptosis, you have exophthalmos. Are they the same? Are they different? Or what it is? Now, let's see what proptosis is first, and then I'll tell you what is exophthalmos. Now, let's imagine this is the orbit. Okay. So this is the bony orbit, right? It's like a cone or like a pyramid with the apex posteriorly. Now, this is a normal eyeball, okay? So this is nice and snugly fits, okay? So this is a normal eyeball. Now, when this eyeball is protruding forward, okay? It's protruding forward. That is called proptosis, yes? So let's use this, okay? So there is a proptosis. It's way beyond the orbital margins, okay? So this is proptosis. Then what is exophthalmos? See, there are so many causes for proptosis. Now, when the cause is a thyroid problem, so if there is an underlying systemic thyroid disease and that causes proptosis, such a proptosis is called as exophthalmos. Okay. So when I say exophthalmos, it is particularly due to thyroid eye disease. All right. So proptosis is the entire, it covers the entire gamut of causes. Whereas when I say exophthalmos, I know for sure that we are dealing with a thyroid problem as the underlying cause of proptosis, okay? Now, there are so many different ways to classify proptosis, or let's say there are various ways of saying, okay, such a type of proptosis. Now, what is it? Now, there is what is called as axial proptosis and non-axial proptosis. So, axial means it's along the axis. Now, what is the axis? Now, let's say this is my eyeball and I have an optic nerve behind it, okay? So, this is how my eyeball is, okay? Now, let's say this eyeball, which is normal within the orbit, it protrudes straight and out, okay? It's not displaced anywhere. So, that is called an axial proptosis. Do you understand? So along its axis, it's just protruding forward. So that is called axial proptosis. Now supposing there is a proptosis, but let's say the eyeball is like this. So that means it's not along its axis, it is non-axial proptosis. Alright? So non-axial, or you can say it's eccentric. It's somewhat different, right? So this is non-axial or eccentric proptosis. Do you understand the difference? So what are the causes of axial proptosis? It's very simple. See, once you know the anatomy, it's going to be so simple. So what is the anatomy? Now let's talk about normal things. Okay. Now, if at all I'm moving forward like this, I'm being pushed forward like this. That means there's somebody exactly behind me giving me that driving force forward, correct? So that means I have some mass which is right behind the eyeball within the orbit, right? So that means maybe I have an optic nerve swelling, a mass of the optic nerve, because you know what is behind the eyeball. Behind the eyeball, I have optic nerve. So if I have a swelling here or a tumor of the optic nerve, obviously it will push the eyeball straight and forward. So for example, optic nerve glioma or optic nerve sheath meningioma, okay? Optic nerve glioma or optic nerve sheath meningioma, right? So these are examples of axial proptosis. Or for example, now behind the eyeball, now let's say I have a vascular lesion, okay? Because you know behind the eyeball, I have my four muscles, okay? So I have four muscles forming a muscular cone. Now, if I have a lesion, a vascular lesion within the muscular cone, for example, a cavernous hemangioma, that's a vascular lesion. So when I have a lesion there, obviously it's going to displace the eyeball, yes, because it is a space occupying lesion. It has a mass, it has a space, it has a volume. So it's going to push the eyeball straight and forward, Okay, so these are examples of axial proptosis. Or for example, I have a cavernous sinus thrombosis. So cavernous sinus thrombosis can spread anteriorly towards the orbit forward because of the presence of valveless veins. So from a cavernous sinus thrombosis, I can get an orbital cellulitis. So again, my orbit is inflamed, the soft tissues in the orbit are inflamed, and that is going to push the eyeball forward. Yes, so again I have an axial proptosis. Okay, now let's look at this non-axial. Now let's say I have eyeball which is protruding but also in an eccentric direction like this. Now you can see here that the eyeball is displaced down and out. It's proptosed and also down and out. So definitely that means, where is my mass? My mass is somewhere here. Yes, so something is here. So something is in the superonasal quadrant which is pushing my eyeball down and out. Do you understand? So this is eccentric proptosis, and what can be the possible causes? Now, so there is a mass here. Now in my previous video, we've talked about rhabdomyosarcoma, and I've told you what is the most common location of rhabdomyosarcoma: superonasal quadrant. So if I have a lesion here, it's going to push my eyeball down and out. So it could be a rhabdomyosarcoma. Or simple things first. What are the simple things? Now suppose I have a frontal sinus mucocele. Okay, so because you know the frontal sinus, it drains into the middle meatus of the nose, and when there is an obstruction, it swells up here. Okay, you have a swelling here. So that swelling will push your eyeball down and out. Or we can have a meningoencephalocele, where there's a bony defect here in this area through which the brain along with its meninges are herniating and pushing the eyeball down and out. So all these are examples of eccentric proptosis. Or now let's say the eyeball is displaced like this, down and in. So that means my lesion is in the superotemporal quadrant. So there's a lesion here which is pushing my eyeball like this. So what is that anatomical structure which is present in the superotemporal quadrant of the orbit? Yes, so that is the main lacrimal gland. So if I have a lacrimal gland mass, okay, a tumor, maybe a benign or a malignant tumor, so it's going to push my eyeball down and in. Okay, so these are all examples of eccentric proptosis. So you know now about axial proptosis, and you also know about non-axial proptosis. So now we'll talk about an interesting thing, what is called as pulsatile proptosis. So now what is this pulsatile proptosis? So if you see this proptosis, the eyeball will be pulsating. Okay, the eyeball will be pulsating, very, very classically seen when you see it from the lateral view. So you'll be seeing the eyeball is pulsating, and if you touch the eyeball, you will feel the pulsation. And sometimes when you keep the, or sometimes, yes, you can also feel the thrill. Okay, so when you place the palm of your hand on the closed eyelids, you'll be able to feel a thrill. And yes, if you're going to keep your stethoscope on top of this pulsating eyeball, you will be able to hear the pulsations. Now, will you be placing the bell of your stethoscope or the diaphragm of your stethoscope? We keep the bell of a stethoscope. Okay, so you place this bell of a stethoscope, be able to hear the pulsations. So what are the causes of this pulsating proptosis? So there are two reasons for this pulsation. So one is, there is an arterial pulsation that is getting transmitted, or it is the brain's pulsation that is transmitted. So why would arterial pulsation be transmitted? See, normally, when you see the vessels, the vascular system, we have arteries, arterioles, you have capillaries, and then you have the venous system. Now, arteries are high pressure systems and veins are low pressure systems. Now, and you also know arteries have pulsations, but the veins do not have pulsations because of this buffering that happens in the capillaries. So if I'm talking about transmitted pulsations, if there's transmitted pulsations, that means there's definitely some problem in the capillary level. So for example, when you have a congenital AVMs, arteriovenous malformations, so the artery gets directly connected to the veins, bypassing the capillaries. So the arterial pulsation gets transmitted. Or number two, you can have a keratico-cavernous fistula. Okay, the carotid artery gets connected with the cavernous system. Cavernous system is a low pressure venous system, right? So that gets connected either by trauma, blunt trauma, or in older people because of atherosclerosis, you can have this spontaneous CCFs. All right. So what are the two causes of pulsating proptosis that you know now? Congenital AVMs and keratico-cavernous fistulas. Now, keratico-cavernous fistulas, typically in the history, if it's a young patient, you will have history of blunt trauma, following which there's a proptosis and there's pulsations and yes. Or if it's an elderly, there'll definitely be a history of systemic hypertension. Now, what about the other one? The other one that I told you is transmitted brain pulsation. Why would brain pulsations be transmitted to the orbit? Only if the bony orbit is defective. Somewhere there's a defect in the bones. For example, you remember the other day we discussed about it? In neurofibromatosis 1, you have this dysplasia of the greater wing of sphenoid, which forms the lateral wall of the orbit. So I have dysplasia, or there is absence of the greater wing of sphenoid. So when that is absent, there is a meningoencephalocele. So the brain along with meninges comes and pushes the eyeball, you know, forward, and also in an eccentric fashion. Yes. So now you know the examples for pulsating proptosis. So now I'm going to give you a little homework, okay? Because I'm not going to teach you everything. There's no spoon feeding. Now you know all this. So I'm going to ask you two questions which you will be commenting in the comment section. So which is intermittent proptosis. I'll explain what is intermittent proptosis. So intermittent means kabhi hai, kabhi nahi hai. Sila nera irukku, sila nera illa. You understand? So at times it is there, sometimes it's not there. That is intermittent proptosis. So you are going to give me two causes of intermittent proptosis. All right. So that is the homework at the end of this video, because I don't want my videos to spoon feed you to the extent that you stop thinking. I want you to think, and I also want you to think about the logic behind the two causes. So let me see. All right. So I want you to give me the examples, and if possible, I also want you to give me the reason behind the intermittent proptosis for these two causes. All right. Okay. Hope you like the video and the explanations behind this, guys. So enjoy proptosis, learning more. There's a lot more than this. So in another video, I'll be talking to you about how to go about a case of proptosis. All right. Thank you.